Good morning, friends. Today I'm going to deliver my lecture on corporate finance management, and the topic of the day is time value of money. So basically, time value of money topic will let you know how the time value of money is to be computed, and the learning objectives of time value money will be like on the screen, how the present and future values are to be computed and what the methods of calculation are there for the time value of money, and how the time value of money helps companies investment alternatives and investments by the manager finance. So basically, time value of money is the money is available, whatever the money is available with you at present is really having a worth more than the money if the same amount is there in the future. So this is basically because of the potential earnings capacity of the money. And time value of money is basically referred to the present discount value as well. Time value of money, the concept of TVM is very clear, because if the time value of money is to be discussed, we'll know the rupee today is worth more than the same amount in the future. Means whatever you have today in your pocket, if you have been put this amount into the bank at a specific rate of interest for a particular time period, definitely after some time we will be getting some more amount from the bankers. And application of time value of money, application of time value of money is done in two kinds of, application is in two kinds, like the one is the compounding, second is discounting. Compounding basically is the process which helps calculate the future value of money, and discounting is the process which helps calculate the present value of money. Factors affects time value of money. There are several factors which affects the time value of money, like the principal amount which is to be invested in projects or the companies. Principal may be one time, lump sum, or the principal may be in annuities. Number of periods, either the periods may be in quarters, in half years or years. Number of times, basically rate of interest also affects the time value of money, because the rate of interest may be simple or the computed. Next, the relationship between future value and present value. The relationship between the future value and present value is basically given on the screen. The future value will always be more than the present value, so present value is to be multiplied with 1 plus I to the power n. Future value of a single amount. Future value of single amount can be calculated by applying the formula, like the SASI is interested to put 10,000 rupee in Yes Bank. And she is interested to get 6% interest from the banker as the bank is offering, and how much he will get after 5 years from now. So after applying the formula, we will see the 13,382 rupee he will be getting after 5 years from the bankers. Next is the same plan is there. He is going to invest the money in the bank or to put the money in saving account. Definitely, if the interest rate is calculated at semi-annual, the formula is to be to be remain the same, but the interest rate is to be divided by 2, and the multiply the time period is to be multiplied by 2, and the interest the total answer of the questions will be 13,439.16. Next, the present value of single amount is to be calculated on the same formula what we have discussed in the relationship between PV and RP. So present value of single amount is to be calculated like, if the salary wants to buy a house after 5 years from now for the 1,50,000, how much he should go to invest in the bank? If the bankers are offering 6% rate of interest in the next 5 years, okay. So if the salary is going to invest this money in the bank at the compound interest rate annually, so definitely after applying formula, you find that she needs to deposit 1,12,088.73 rupees. Today, 0.73 paise today for the future, buying house purchase for the rupee 1,50,000. And the same, if the money is to be invested for the on the basis of semi-annual interest rate, so definitely the formula will remain same, but the interest and the periods are to be calculated separately. The divide, the annual and interest rate is to be divided by 2 to make it semi-annual, and number of years are to be multiplied by 2 to make it semi-annual. So definitely the answer will be 1,11,614 rupees. She just need to invest in the bank today for if she is interested to purchase a house for 1,50,000 after just 5 years from here. dear friends, thank you for watching the video.